everyone, and welcome to Dice for Roll, the greatest Pathfinder podcast on the planet, where you ask the hard question like, if you clone yourself with magic and then kill the clone, is it murder or suicide?
It is murder.
It's murder because you're still alive.
Yeah, like, technically the clone is, I don't know, clones are more like
clones
siblings than yourself, because you don't share a consciousness.
Yeah.
Okay, I do a counterpoint.
Okay.
You just killed yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's suicide. Not suicide.
Why not?
It's different. Because it's not you.
Okay.
Your clone isn't literally you, it's just got all of your genetics.
Okay, what if you had your consciousness sent into the clone first?
But it's not yours anymore. It's a copy of your consciousness.
What if your entire consciousness was in that clone?
Okay, you, then like, it's suicide. If
your original body is alive.
Yeah, but you are not your body only. You
obviously
are your consciousness.
Obviously, this is a fucking special case where you have two bodies, one of which is a fucking clone of you with your consciousness. So I guess, yeah, in this special case, you can kill yourself twice if you really wanted to.
Follow-up question.
Okay.
Would it be gay to do that?
Yes.
No, what?
What?
Like, you know, is it gay to fuck your clone? Is it gay to kill your clone in a suicide pact?
It would probably be gay to have sex with your clone, but to kill them,
no. One brought sex up. I don't know where you're getting
this from.
You did!
You just did!
You said the word fuck.
What kind of gaslighting is this? You just brought up fucking your own clone. What do you mean no one brought up sex? I'm gonna fucking push you down the stairs.
Killing? I'm a... Guys, I'm about to say something that's gonna scare some of the gay people.
Okay.
Killing somebody is not a romantic or a sexual act, I promise.
You're scaring Ritz.
Take it back. Take it back. I'm sorry that you're wrong.
Okay. You know what? We've been unhinged with our last few questions. would we like to play some Pathfinder?
Yes.
Okay. So, previously in Fists of the Ruby Phoenix, day 4 of the tournament came and went, and our heroes, the Radiant Winds, watched as the loser's bracket first round came to its thrilling conclusion, as Speakers to the Wind and Winter's Roar were eliminated from the Ruby Phoenix tournament, and Tino's Toughest and the Biting Roses were able to advance. Following the day and an extremely thrilling match around the Ruby Tower, Sanku conversed with Sigrid Beale and the party went home a little later than usual. Only to be... What's the word? Only to be followed by a mysterious pair of Jiangshi tieflings by the name of Lord Ryong and Lady Yi, Devil's Dues, Moonlight Requiem. They now stand challenging you, as Masami has turned the tables on them and is now following them. Nobody knows how they became Jiangshi, especially Jiangshi as powerful as they are, and a lot of questions have been raised. Questions which will be answered if you can take them alive, or should I say, undead. And we're going to immediately hop into character.
Okay.
Set the scene. Sanku and Chuji, the two of you stand in a dead-end alleyway, and between you and the wall are Devil's Dew's Requiem, Lady Yi and Lord Ryong. Standing behind them atop a rooftop is Masami Takahara, weapon drawn and mirror image flickering. Masami is charging up a spell as the two Jiangshi leap into battle, and all of you are looking a little bit shocked. Before we hop into battle and roll initiative, my question is, how is everyone doing right now?
Sanku is annoyed that he had just had a very, very productive conversation for his mental health, and now he has to deal with the most annoying people that he's ever met.
Yeah, you do not have a good track record with these guys. First they flirted with you, then they tried to kill the Ruby Phoenix, now they're doing this.
I like the implication that flirting with Sanku is as bad as, like, killing the Ruby Phoenix.
It's a little bit worse, actually.
It is worse.
That's true.
I think Chuji's just really fucking confused. I don't think they've had the time to reason out anything. Devil's Dues is no Jiangxi. And, like, powerful Jiangxi, too. And they're just, like... That's such a massive fucking thing to drop on someone so suddenly.
Yeah, this is not a reversible process, either. This is something that, like, happens to you, and that's it.
Forever, and you don't ever get to not be it.
Yeah. So I think maybe it's a little startling for this, because like you did like try pull off the Fulus to see if it was a disguise. Yeah. It's not. They're real.
They're fucking real.
You did every Scooby-Doo movie where they're like, oh, it's another guy in a mask, and they try to take the mask off and it doesn't come off. They're like, ruh-roh.
Yeah, they're like, ah, oh, they're fucking around. They're not.
They are not. Masami, how about you?
At this point, they can't see that they're Jiangxi. Like, they can't. All they know is that Devil's Dues is down there.
Mm-hmm.
They could tell by the annoying voices. So, at this point, I think they think that they are still, like, regular tieflings. They don't. They also don't know how much they have been training before. They seem pretty okay, powerful, but at the same time, their stealth job was trash. So, like...
garbage ninja tactics.
Yeah. When you're trying to sneak up on a ninja, you can't. So, they're still running on, like, old Devil's Dues. They don't know yet, so they're feeling at least a little bit confident. Can't wait for that to tank.
Yep. Devil's Dues themselves, however, both of them stand on one leg back to back and they pose, and Lord Ryong says, "Now everyone, you're gonna see what happens when you mess with the best!" And Lady Yi poses and says, "We're getting our revenge, Requiem style!" And everyone, I want you all to roll me initiative.
God.
42.
36.
30.
Alright. So unfortunately, it looks like Devil's Dues got to drop on you because they rush forward with supernatural speed with a 48 and a 46 to initiative.
Good God.
And top of the order is gonna be Lord Ryong. And Ryong lurches towards you, Sanku, getting up in your space in a single hop. And he gets up to your face and he grins and he says... "Hey again, baby. Let's see what your key tastes like."
Ew.
And he is going to enter a stance of debt, allowing perfect body control over himself. And he's going to enter Bone Corp stance. You don't know what that's going to do? But I'm sure we'll find out in a second. That was a free action, thanks to the Jiangxi's premonition of debt. So one action to get up to you. And then he's going to try to get you with his claw. And he slashes at you with these supernaturally long nails. And that is going to be a hit with a 45 to hit.
Yeah, that works.
Okay, well, he's going to do 3d10 plus 15 piercing damage as his nails dig into your throat.
Gross.
That's going to be 34 damage to you.
Okay.
And then he's going to try to grab you. He does it automatically. You're grabbed. He's got you by the throat. He can't use that claw again because he's got you by the throat. But now that he has you, he kind of grins and says, "I'm guessing an umami taste, or maybe from a fish boy, a little salty." And then he opens his mouth and begins to breed. And as he does, Sanku, from those wounds in your throat, weird mist starts to seep out. He's draining your very life force.
Well, that's quite awful. That's quite bad.
He's going to need to make an athletics check against you. And that is going to be a 41 against your fortitude DC.
Yeah. Yeah, that okay. works.
Well, you are drained. Your life force starts to kind of flow out of you. And your legs start to, like, knock a little bit, Sanku. Like, as this is happening, you're about to faint at any second. And that's Bone Corp stance kicking in. When Lord Ryong successfully drains ki while in the stance, for one round, each time you attempt to stride, you'll need to make a flat check or waste the action and fall prone. As you are drained, you'll have a penalty to your fortitude saves, and on top of that, you have lost a set amount number of HP permanently until the end of this fight. That's not great. Next is going to be Lady Yi. And Lady Yi, she kind of spins those musical orbs in the air and says, I don't need music right now when I've got Jiangshi prowess! And she flicks it behind her, you know, to make the music keep going. But she's not barding right now. She's killing. She rushes up to you, Chuji, and she's also going to enter a stance. This one is Cloudless Void Stance. So she actually doesn't stand up next to you. She's still 10 feet away from you, Chuji. But she flicks her hands and her nails get really long and she starts moving kind of like almost like she's a dream, you know? She's moving very slowly and flowy.
Yeah.
And she is going to slash at you, Chuji. Uh-oh.
Jesus Christ.
That's a nat 20.
It sure is.
Well, Chuji, how does 64 damage sound?
Oh, it sounds like damage I'm taking.
Yep. She throws that at you and it slashes into you and honestly cuts through some of your veins nearly.
Ow.
It feels really weird and bad. Mm. And she kind of smirks a little bit as she bows and says, did you like that? Because there's more of that where that came from. And she's automatically going to grab you. And with her last action, she is just going to slash at you again. And that is a 38, which is a hit.
Yes.
And Chuji, that's going to be 25 more damage.
All right.
Masami, it is your turn. I think by now you figured something is up, because Lady Yi just elongated her nails and then grabbed Chuji from a distance with them as they wrap around their body. And Lord Ryong is seeping a weird mist from Sanku's throat. These are not the same abilities you remember the Bard and the Barbarian having on Danger Island.
Yeah, Masami also heard Jiangshi. When they hear that, they say, what? Okay. Fucking new tactics, I guess. Jesus Christ. They don't know a lot about Jiangshi, I don't think. Probably only what Chuji has told them.
Mm-hmm.
So right now, I think they're running off of improv. I think Masami's gonna tap into their Kitsune magic finally.
Okay.
They are going to cast Death Ward on Senku.
Okay, and what's Death Ward do?
You shield a creature from the ravages of negative energy. It receives a +4 status bonus against saves against death and negative effects. Gains negative resistance 10 and suppresses the effects of the doomed condition.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. All right, go for that.
So I think what happens is there is a kind of a reason why Masami hasn't used them, because 8 tails form from there too.
Okay. Kind of showing your full potential now as you stand showing off your Kitsune might, which you usually keep hidden, right?
Yes.
I like that. Sweet. Okay. Here you go, Sanku.
Thank you.
Okay, Masami, you do that, and Sanku perks up immediately. It looks like he's going to be a little... You hope he's going to be okay, because that looks like it fucking hurt.
Right. Then I think they're just going to dimensional salt and try to hit Ryong from behind.
Okay.
That is a 48.
That's a fucking crit, Masami. You teleport behind him and fucking run a sword through his gut. And on anyone else, that would have been a lethal takedown kill. But he lets out a gasp and he looks over his shoulder at you with these white eyes, and you see that fluttering Fulu scroll and the rigor mortis that's seized over him. And he just grins, and you feel grossed out by that for many reasons. Do you want to do that damage real fast?
Yeah, that's 38 damage.
38 damage, okay.
And then because of their haste, they're going to try to attack again.
Okay, go for it.
41.
41 is a fucking hit.
25 damage.
Okay, Masami, you slash, but you can tell that both of these hits don't seem to be hurting him all that much. Which is to say, you think he might have a resistance of some kind. And Chuji, you know that Jiangshi are resistant to all physical damage, except for a certain kind which they're weak to. You're not sure off the top of your head, but you know that physical attacks are something, because they're literally rigor mortis, right? They're corpses.
Yeah.
So he turns as you're doing this and says, "Oh, you hurt me so bad, baby. I'm just going to have to drink this little guy up like he's a fucking bottle of sake."
Do that and I'll have your head.
He kind of, you know, sticks his tongue out, Murdoch Nichols style. It's gross. You fucking hate this guy.
Oh, God.
Apparently becoming a Jiangshi just made him worse.
Yeah.
It was such a low bar to begin with. Man, it was...
He fucking did the limbo under it. Is that your turn?
That's their turn.
Okay. Chuji, you are standing 10 feet away from Lady Yi, and yet she's holding you with these curling nails that are wrapped around you from a distance.
Gross.
With her free hand, she makes a "come on" gesture at you, like, "Oh, what's the matter? Can't hit me from over there? Oh."
Damn, girl, that's crazy. I got into fucking jellyfish stance.
Damn, bitch, that's crazy. Anyway.
That's so fucked up, dude.
Damn, shardy.
So you are, by the way, right now, you're grabbed, right? Uh-huh. You are held in place, you're flat-footed, and you're immobilized. So your AC is lowered, and you can't move away from this position. And if you make a manipulate action, you have to roll for it.
Do I have to roll to Stinging Lash?
No, you can fucking slap the shit out of her from where you are.
Good. That's great. I'm gonna Flurry of Blows Stinging Lash. Just fucking slap her shit. For 43 and a 35.
Yeah, 43 is gonna be a hit, 35 is gonna be a miss. You swing twice at her from where you are, and one actually does catch her in the face, and she looks like, as she stumbles back, a little surprised. How much damage is that?
That's gonna be 26 damage.
Okay. You slap her again. She does not take as much damage as you would have liked her to take. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Would you like to make me a free religion check to see what you can remember? If you can remember what kind of physical they're weak to?
Sure.
Or occultism. I'll allow you occultism.
Okay. Well, occultism, that's going to be 38.
Okay. Chuji, your heart sinks because it isn't an answer you like.
Hmm.
Magical dark wood.
Fuck.
It has to be a specially treated type of wood, usually made from a peach tree. You don't have any of those on you, do you?
Oh my god, wait.
What? What?
Isn't that what Chuji's necklace is made out of?
Is it?
I'm pretty sure I made the beads on it, like peach wood.
Oh my god.
I'm pretty sure we had a whole conversation about it.
Oh my god.
I think
god.
It's on the character reference sheet that we gave to our artist.
Okay. You know what? I will allow that, because it seems in character, and it's extremely funny.
Yeah, because I'm pretty sure Chuji, of all people, will have protection against Jiangshi.
Yeah, you know what? Sure, Chuji. I will let you beat people to death with your fucking...
Yeah, improvised Chuji... weapon necklace.
Could Chuji take the giant necklace of stained red giant peachwood balls off their neck and beat her to death with it?
I will, if you, it'll take an action to take it off and use
that's
it like a weapon.
That's fine.
But yes, I will allow it.
Okay, what do I need to roll for that?
You just take it off and then you start using it as a weapon.
Oh yeah, for to hit her.
Oh, just, I will say Stinging Lash, but we'll count it as Darkwood. This will be at a minus 10 though.
That's fine. What if I used a hero point for that one?
Yeah, you did get a crit fail, which would have been bad.
It would have been pretty bad. Fuck. Alright, 35.
A 35 is a miss, which is better than a crit fail, because I would have taken that necklace right off.
That's fair, and I don't want you to do that.
She kind of ducks her head to the side as you do that and says, "Oh, you're more flexible than you look, Master Shi. I'll have to break your limbs to make sure you don't do that again."
You have fun with that, freak.
And she is slowly dragging you closer, ready to pierce your neck and drink your ki. And, Chuji, is that your turn?
Yeah.
Okay. Senku, which prince of the sea? Ah, jeez. Lord Ryong has got you, and he is draining you. Thankfully, Masami has debt ward on you, so negative energy will hurt you a little less, but, life does suck for you right now, and your legs feel particularly weak. On your shoulder, Lolo lets out a "Sanku, watch out! Those appear to be Jiangshi, hopping vampires!"
Thank you, Lolo.
Can I get out of this grapple?
Yeah, sure, go for it. You'd have to make me an athletics, acrobatics, or attack roll.
I'm going with an acrobatics roll. 28.
A 28 is unfortunately going to be a fail. He is clutching you by the throat, and it is a tight grip.
I'm doing it again because I really don't want to be in there. 42.
Ah, that does it. Thank you. You kick, you struggle, and then you push yourself off this guy's nails, and you kind of clutch your throat, which isn't bleeding. It's just smoke coming out of it, out of these puncture wounds in you.
Okay. He's going to back away 25 feet.
Okay, you're dashing the other way, right?
Yeah.
Okay, Sanku, as you're running, you feel really weak in the knees. Can you make me a flat check, please?
Yes, that's this one. 18.
Sanku, as you're running, you feel your knees almost give out from the bone corpse stance of death that Ryong used on you. But you push through and you're fine. Okay. It is Lord Ryong's turn. And Lord Ryong kind of cracks his back as you get away, Sanku. And he turns and looks at you, Masami. And he grins. And Masami, you can see where you ran him through with your sword a moment ago. It's starting to heal up already. He has fast healing. And he grins and says, "What's the matter? Can't handle the heat? Your little Tino Tung isn't here to save you this time. It's us versus you."
Bold of you to assume that I needed Tino.
Did they think this?
I just love him. Goddamn.
He is going to enter a different stance. This one is going to be Sundered Veins. Rather than going to stab, he moves his hands so it's like he's going to go for a chop instead. And he does. He does chop. He chops at your throat, Masami, with his claws. Ka-chow! That's going to be a 37, which is just a hit.
That is my AC.
Okay. That's going to be 3d10 plus 15 piercing. And you're going to take 39 damage from it. And then, from where he chopped you, you start gushing blood. You are bleeding now. And he kind of like pulls his claws back and licks his... Blood is such an acquired taste, baby. But it really does grow on you. Gross.
Gross.
He is then going to, I think he's going to try trip you, Masami.
Okay.
He sweeps his leg underneath you, and that is going to be a 39 against your reflex DC.
Hey, wait a second.
Hmm?
My mirror image is still up.
Oh, shit. Okay. Yeah, let me roll that D4 to see if he actually was able to hit you. One.
Mirror image... Chance of hitting you is 1 in 4. So, yeah, okay. 1 on 1d4. So, yeah, he hits.
Yeah, okay, so he did hit you this time. But let's see which D Alex rolled to trip you. That's a 4. Okay, this time he misses. He sweeps the legs of one of the things and it... into mist. And he goes... Ugh. Fancy tricks, huh? Well, you can't beast us! We're the best of best! Okay. All right,
then
guys.
Why didn't you hit me?
Oh, motherfucker. He's going to try to get you one last time. He's mad about that. Ooh. You goaded him real good.
Miss.
That's a crit fail. Well, in that case, he is going to battered. Until he is healed, he takes a -2 penalty to checks and saving throws. Basically... I think he rushes up to you, and I think you like almost reflectively just deck him in the face a little bit, and I think you punch a tooth out. And he stumbles back and hey, what the fuck? Bitch, punch my teeth out! And lady, he's like,
"What's
don't worry.
Wrong? You can't handle the heat?
Fuck you!" And lady, he's like, "Don't fall for their taunts, Garam. Come on, it'll grow back. You're a Jiangshi
now." Oh, please, he's easy to taunt. The stupid ones are.
I'm not dumb.
Then why can't you hit me?
Lady Yi just rolls her eyes. She's not dealing with this shit. Lady Yi, from where she is, she says, "All right, now let's just get this over with, shall we?" She is going to make a focus spell on you, Chuji.
Okay.
Medusa's Wrath. She makes an attack filled with a Medusa's petrifying power. She's going to try turn you to stone, Chuji.
Okay.
And so she needs to make an attack roll against you. And that is going to be a 36, which would normally be a miss. Except she has you grabbed, and she's pulling you closer, and you can't dodge out as easily as you would like.
I'm going to fucking kill you.
So she hits you, and she's going to do 21 damage to you. But on a success, you must make me a fortitude save at the end of each of your turns to avoid being slowed, as when she hits you, stone starts to spread over from the point of impact.
Okay.
And she kind of grins as this is happening. And Chuji, feels cold. Ooh, it's like your nerve endings are going solid. Oh. And she grins and says, "Oh, what's the matter? It looks like you don't have all your fight in you. Oh, could it be you're all worn out after your precious Ruby Phoenix tournament?
What is your fucking issue with us?
You humiliated us, so we're going to kill you."
You did that really easily yourself.
Shut up, she says, and she smacks you. That's a crit. That's a crit. She's fucking bitch slapped. Not 20.
That's pretty good.
That's pretty funny. Okay, Chuji, that's going to be 54 damage to you. Ouch. She fucking decks you across the face. She, like, slaps you across the face as hard as she can. That hurt.
Ow.
And she sneers at you. She's still clutching you with her claws and says, "This will be too easy. Revenge is going to be, sour, I think, judging by the taste of your blood." She licks her claw.
The fuck?
They don't even drink blood. They're doing this for fun. Jiangxi don't drink blood.
What do you mean blood? What the fuck are you talking about?
Masami, it's your turn. You are bleeding, but you have Ryong's attention. You distracted him from Sanku.
I think they are going to spell strike with a gouging claw.
Okay.
It's a 41.
41 is going to be a nice and juicy hit. Roll me that damage.
Okay, so that is 21 damage from the blade.
Okay.
And
which he takes a little bit less of.
Gouging claw attack that does 25 damage.
Okay, yeah. He takes all of that immediately, for sure.
That has Masami's interest.
He kind of stumbles back as the gouging claw actually hits into him. And lets it... And he sees you looking interested and says, "Don't read into it too much. You just got lucky with a grazing hit."
Or, "You don't like magic."
Shut up!
They go into Arcane Cascade.
Uh-oh.
Not where that ends, because I also go into... Where is it? Arcane Shroud.
Okay, and what's the Arcane Shroud here?
Arcane Shroud for Transmutation gives me Fleet Step, so I am... plus 30 feet faster.
Okay, cool. Is that your turn?
No.
Oh my fucking god.
Remember, I can still strike with the Chocto.
Yes, you can. Go for it.
Alright, well that one doesn't hit. That's 33.
33 is unfortunately going to be a miss. He ducks out away this time, powered up by his spite. Chuji and Masami, you take 2 bleed damage.
Okay,
Chuji, it is your turn. You got a patch of stone that's starting to grow. You're gonna have to deal with that at the end of your turn.
Great.
But not yet. You're good for now. Chuji, you have 3 actions. You are grabbed by this bitch. What do you do?
Can I make it like a strength check to be not grabbed?
Yeah, make me an Alex roll. Or an attack roll if you like. You can straight up make a martial attack roll to punch out of there.
46.
Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Chuji, you push out of her nails and you like, kind of hop back a step and she shakes her hand a little bit in pain, but she hisses and she's going for you again.
Ugh.
What do you do?
Chuji continues to try to beat the shit out of her with with those beads. Can I 2-action one inch punch with...
With jellyfish sense? Absolutely.
Yeah. Oh, with the beads, I mean.
Oh, yes, absolutely. Shit! Okay, that's a 50 to hit, guys. Chuji, you fucking... How'd you hit her with this this dark wood?
I think that, like, Chuji was, like, missing before, and their attacks, like, weren't doing much damage. And they're getting kind of frustrated. So honestly, I think when they take off their necklace, they just like whap her across the fucking face, and it's like such a hearty hit that you can like hear it from like down the street.
Crack, crack, crack.
Yeah, it's a real meaty blow.
Mm-hmm.
Just right across the jaw, and that's going to be 66 damage.
And she takes the full tang here. No resistance as you like fucking beat her in the face. She stumbles back, eyes wide, and she's clutching her jaws like, oh, ow, what is that? Ugh.
That's peachwood, baby.
What's peachwood?
You're a Jiangshi and you don't know what peachwood is?
I mean, of course I do. What do you take me for? She enters a martial stand. She's ready to kick your ass. It's Chuji. You're getting really weird feelings from this whole encounter.
I don't like this. With their last action, I don't think there's anything I could roll to learn more about them. Because without, like, talking to them, I don't think they can figure anything else out.
Mm-mm. You can make a perception check. I'll give you a perception check to see if you want to figure something out.
Maybe, but I think right now I know all that I need to.
Okay.
I'm going to flurry of blows. Last action.
You are so funny, Ritz. This won't explode in your face.
Totally.
Let's see.
Damn! That's a crit fail and a fail.
Well, actually, the second one is a hit. The first one is a crit fail, though.
Oh, okay.
So, Chuji, you hit her once, and you do 22 damage to her, which she does not like, but then she grabs you by the wrist again, and she pulls you in, and Chuji, you are grappled once again.
Fuck off.
And she says, "Which did you go with, baby?"
What?
Get it? Like the song? Forget about it. Anyway, she's got you. She's clutching your wrist, Chuji, preventing you from fleeing further. As your turn ends, I need you to make me a fortitude save, please.
Okay.
Because, ouch, that stone's starting to spread.
44.
The stone falls off. It just crumbles off. You're fine. I think you're made of much stronger stuff. As Jiangshi is good at paralyzing and incapacitating weaker people, you are quite strong, though.
Yeah.
Sanku, everything hurts. You are drained. Some of your life force was straight up sapped out of you. And you've stumbled back about 30 feet away from everyone else. Right now, Lord Garam and Lady Yi are kind of like in the back of this dark alley. And Chuji is pretty close by. What do you do?
The problem is that you've handed me the undead.
Uh-oh.
I'm going to cast Moonburst so that it doesn't hit Chuji. Masami will be in this, but there's every chance that they won't take the damage at all. And also, they're not undead, so it's a lot easier.
Moonburst with Fortitude or a Reflex?
That is a Reflex.
Okay, I should be fine.
Yeah, okay. You'll also, regardless, take 8d10 less damage than everybody else is taking.
Oh, that's fair. Oh, right. This is like the moon version of fucking Siri Light, right?
Yeah. I need a reflex save from both of them.
Uh-oh. Well, that's going to be a success just about from Yi.
Ooh. Okay.
Oh, God.
Oh no, that's a crit fail from Ryong. He failed by 9, but because what was it that gave him -2 earlier?
His crit fail from earlier from Masami taunting him.
Tee-hee. Yeah, he crit failed and now he's like up in Masami's grill, and I think Masami grabs him and throws him deeper into the explosion when it happens.
And that's probably why Masami like takes damage actually.
Yeah, a ball of white light appears behind everyone. Masami, you grab Ryong and spin him into it, and then it explodes at full force. So Lady Yi is going to take half damage of your total ting. Your total ting was what? 52?
52.
Okay, so she's going to take 26 damage, and Lord Ryong is going to take double damage, which is enough to fucking explode him and kill him. Well, not kill him.
Yeah, I was like, oh god.
You'll see. Normally, this would disintegrate an undead. But what you see happen from Lord Ryong is this explosion rocks into him and he lets it out. and he stumbles, but instead of disintegrating, he folds up into a corpse on the floor. His arms cross over, and his, like, he loses all signs of being a Jiangshi. He is frozen solid in place. And Chuji, you know that that is a Jiangshi's special ability. One more breath. Unlike other undead, a Jiangshi is not destroyed at zero HP. Instead, they fall unconscious and awaken 1 minute later with one HP. Now, there are ways to prevent them from you know, getting out, but we'll deal with that afterwards. Point is, Lord Ryong is KO. Lady Yi looks over and says, Ryong, no! You've killed him, you monsters!
He's not dead.
What?
What?
He's a cor-
Do you not know how your powers work?
Who fucking did this to you?
Never mind, my friend. I'll get you out of here. Thank you. You got one action out over there. Chuji's looking pretty fucked up. Lord Rong is even more fucked up because he's KO. And Lady Yi seems to be trying to take flight. Get out of here. What do you do?
Yeah, I'll use life boost on Chuji.
Okay. Good call, because Chuji is pretty badly injured by the looks of it.
Looking pretty shit.
Here you go.
Okay. Chuji, that is going to be... That's going to work for you. You're going to restore 16 hit points. Lord Rong is KO. Lady Yi is going to hop over. And as she's hopping, actually, Chuji and Masami, both of you are unable to make attack of opportunities against her.
Why?
Because she's using Jiangshi Hop.
What a piece of shit.
Which avoids it.
Fuck you.
And she takes an action to pick up Rong and says, you may have won this time, but this isn't the last you've seen of Devil's Juice. And she starts to fucking hop away at half speed with Lord Rong on her shoulder, which isn't very far, let's be real. She gets 15 feet away. Masami, it's your turn.
Here's the She's thing, though. Masami has fleet step from Arcane Shroud.
Oh, fuck. Okay. Okay. Say what you're going to say.
Along with
do.
Their two remaining clones, fucking jump up the roof ninja style in front of her.
Okay. She goes, ah!
Oh,
and she
come
almost
on,
drops
beautiful. Where are you going?
She just makes a face at you like, shit,
I think
shit,
they're
shit.
Probably going to take their dancing Kusarigama and try to trip her so that way she falls down to the floor.
Oh, cool.
40.
Make me that electrol. That's a crit. Which means she's going to fall. I'm going to say she's. This is less a trip and more of a shove. Like, you
I
fucking
Sparta kick
her
off her off the floor.
Her.
Off the fucking roof.
She goes, ah! And she falls and falls and crack! And she immediately folds up on herself. And she is KO. And they both are. Devil's Jews. Fucking Jiangshi. What the fuck, guys?
Senku sort of walks over. He's like, I don't feel so good.
You okay?
Yeah. He sort of rubs his neck. He's like, it made me a little nervous.
Senku, you've got holes in your neck.
Oh no, I'm gonna turn into a vampire.
Oh, don't worry, that's not how that works.
Exactly.
I know, I'm kidding.
Now, if we wish to destroy these foul creatures, there's only one thing for it. We need to scatter glutinous rice or hen eggs around them. When they wake up, they will be destroyed.
Well, we're not gonna... Lolo.
Come now, Chuji. Give us... You have eggs or rice, right?
What? No, I don't... We're not gonna destroy them. We're gonna get some fucking answers out of them.
Lolo, they have answers. We need to know what they are.
Oh,
yeah, they didn't even know.
Clever.
Hold on, we gotta do this fast. And he's like, does anybody have rope?
Oh, oh god. Oh, fuck.
Senku, use your tether spell.
Oh, actually, yeah.
Wait, use your red string of fate spell.
Like, I'm sorry?
To tie them together.
Oh, but they'll still run away.
No, they'll be tied together.
But they can still run away from us.
They can run away together.
Use the rope to tie them up with the spell.
Just tie him up!
Lord Ryong's like,
he
oh my god.
And he casts it. And he's like, oh gosh. But he's trying to hold them.
Chuji's holding them in place, yeah.
Okay.
Masami has a force fang ready just in case.
Okay. Well, a red string wraps around the boat and ties them together, which is extremely embarrassing. Eventually, the two of them start coming to. And I think Ryong wakes up first and is like, I'm alive! Get me out of here! Get me out of here!
No.
Get
That's not happening.
Masami, I think, takes their dancing kusarigama, wraps the chain around his neck, puts their knee against their back from behind him, and goes, shut the fuck up.
He goes quiet.
That's because you hurt me.
All right.
He looks very smug about it.
Lady Yi starts to wake up, and she's like, I'm alive. Get me out of here! Get me out of here!
Chuji, I think...
necklace.
Yeah. Chuji's got their necklace in their hands still. And I think they, like, kneel down in front of him. Not, like, kneel, but, like, kind of squat.
Mm-hmm.
And they're just kind of squinting, and they're like, you really don't know what you are, do you?
We're mighty Zhangxi. We know all about it. After all, we underwent a serious ritual to get here.
Ritual, yeah. Huh? From who?
We figured it out on our own, of course. Only the best for the
Masami
greatest.
Tightens the chain around Yi's neck. Tell the truth.
Yi looks over like, we are telling the truth. We... Look, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know anything. I don't know anything. I don't know.
What do you mean if you don't know?
Well, I let go of Wrong. You're hurting him. He needs those vocal cords.
Not until I get the answers. What do you mean?
There's no answer. I don't know.
Okay. I think that we're getting nowhere.
That's right, everyone. Use your hen eggs and rice.
No.
Lola.
Why would we have hen eggs and rice? I'm not even hungry.
That kills Zhangxi.
What? Oh no, I like hen eggs and rice.
Isn't that unfortunate? Anyways,
nice maybe you should have done some research before turning into Zhangxi.
We didn't.
So, you became Zhangxi.
Yes, Lady grits her teeth.
Did you die escaping, or did you survive and then decide to do that?
We didn't escape. I don't know where you're getting that from.
It says that you escaped off the boat. You just jumped off.
No. What the fuck? You think we're idiots? We don't know how to swim.
And what happened?
Whoa.
They glance at each other and they seem... Ryong's like, hey, maybe they can help us. Maybe they can, like, undo this?
Maybe. We'll see if you have the right information.
Did you get turned into Zhangxi?
Lady Yi says, radiant winds, you are disgusting scumbags who used the spotlight to your advantage. But if you help us with this, maybe we'll call it evens.
With what?
Yeah, it depends on what you need help with. And why.
Well, our whole situation, it's less than ideal for being pop stars.
Right, and killing the...
Hey, that would have been really good for our image with a certain crowd, you know what I mean? But with being Zhangxi, we can't go out during the day anymore.
I'll tell you what. You tell us everything, and I'll tell you how to cure being a Zhangxi.
He kind of exhales and looks at you and says, we were asleep in ourselves. We were kind of fucked because we had these anti-magic rings. So we had no intention of escaping, and we figured out, hey, some people get really popular doing tours from within prisons, you know?
Okay.
Fair.
And Lady Yi bites her lip and says, but then, in the middle of the night, a portal opened, right in front of us.
A portal?
Yes. And someone walked through the portal? I don't remember them, but they... They opened the door and spoke and told us to enter. And we did. I don't know if we had any ability to say no.
Like, they mind-controlled you? Or, like, influenced you?
No, it felt like mind-control. Like, we had to. And Lord Rong speaks and says, then we entered this weird place where everything was mirrors and... There were these five people, and then, a lot of pain from the one who walked through the portal, and then we woke up like this. We both agreed we had to go kick your ass.
Our ass.
You guys, Radiant Winds, it was the first thing on our minds. You humiliated us, Danger Islands, and now you have to pay.
Uh-huh.
The one that you spoke to, did you recognize, like, a tone of voice? Man's or woman's?
I think Lady Yi rolls her eyes like it's obvious and opens her mouth and then furrows her brows. I don't know. I knew them at the time, but I don't now.
Do you remember being surprised at who they were?
Lord Ryong tilts his head and says, yeah, I actually think so. I think we knew them.
Do you know from where?
I can't say.
You knew them, though.
Yeah, I recognized them. Well, I think I did.
They wiped your memory.
Lola, we don't have it. Is it possible to learn any spells about memories?
Lolo hums his. Yes, it's not impossible to have spells that rewrite people's minds. But it's powerful magic.
And there's no way that we could, that you could teach me a spell that would help with this?
I'm sorry, Sanku, but you're a primal caster. I teach you the ways of the living world. If you wanted something to do with minds, you'd really need an occult caster, and quite a strong one. Someone whose power is over the soul and the mind.
And I'm arcane.
Misami, do you know anybody that might be able to help?
Misami goes through their list of people that they know from the fucking Golden League.
The phone book in their head.
Would you like to make me an underworld lore check, please?
Okay. This has never come into use until now.
Well, you're going through your underworld contacts.
Okay. All right. 37.
Okay. I think you know of people, but it could take you up to a week for them to get here.
Shit. Last time I saw Hiroshi, I saw the people who... I saw his roster that was out of town, and a lot of the occult casters are out right now. It could be up to a week for them to get here. I don't know where they are. Of course he's not going to put specifics on where they are.
Then there's nothing we can do. We're at a dead end again.
Not necessarily. We still know that it's people that you might have known, or recognized at least, and that's not nothing.
I don't even know how many of them I did recognize. It could have been one, it could have been all of them.
Exactly. With no names, we don't have any leads.
We know 5, so could honestly be anybody.
Lolo looks at you, Misami, and says, what about asking them about you know who?
All right. I am going to need the absolute truth from both of you.
And Lord Rungskar says, have we been anything but honest?
They tighten the chains. Serious.
We're being serious, Lady Yi nods feverishly.
Do you know about the Oni's mask?
Lord Ryong blinks one eye at a time, and Lady Yi says, of course we know about the Oni's mask. No, we don't. No, we don't know anything, I'm sorry.
Fuck. And while you've been telling us, you haven't seen anyone else try to tell us either?
Lady Yi furrows her brow a little bit and says, I mean, there was that one guy.
One guy?
One guy. Was he an old man with, like, shoulder-length hair?
Yeah, kind of raggedy-looking.
So he wasn't one of yours.
One of what?
I think Misami takes their, I think Misami takes the chain off of, Ryong's neck and stows it.
Wait, I don't need to breathe. This is great.
There was another person telling us. Raggedy, old-looking, couldn't get the man's face, but... Even when I tried to lure him into an alleyway, it didn't work. He just disappeared within 20 seconds.
They both look at each other, then they look back at you and they shrug.
So you're a singular job, okay?
Cool. Ugh.
They might be trying to throw us off.
Probably. But wait, throw us off of what?
Trying to pick all the pieces together. They're trying to give us dead ends. All everywhere. This is one of them. And if they found these two dead on the floor, who are they? Who do you think it's gonna fall on?
Ugh. Fuck me.
Our best option is to find the person who is tailing us for real.
Lolo nods a little bit and says, that does sound like a good plan of action. But they've proven to be quite a slippery character so far, haven't they?
We just have to keep a better eye out.
He nods and says, indeed. But what are we going to do with these two?
Yeah.
Lady Swan says, well, you're going to turn us back into people now, aren't you?
Oh, I lied. There's no cure for being a Xiaoxi. You're gonna have to learn to live with that.
I mean, aren't you literally undead?
But yeah, you can't really cure undeadness.
Yeah.
You know that, right? Yeah. Is you actually believe me?
They both look really fucking sour. Lord Rungnod says, I taught you how to way out. We can't be stuck like this. It's so bad for our image.
Have you guys ever heard of night concerts?
Yeah, it's like a whole thing.
But we don't want to be goths forever.
You don't have to be goth.
You can be like rave people.
Yeah, raves are at night, right? Yeah.
Most concerts are at night.
Yeah. Plus you'd be like, I don't know, mysterious or whatever. I don't even know why I am. Size.
This is another audience that you can cater to, don't you think?
Yeah.
Two of them look sad. We built up our own army of fans, though.
Yeah, but how many of them do you think are going to think vampires are hot?
Lots of people do.
Yeah.
The two of them exchange looks as, well, it's the hand we've been dealt. Untie us and we'll hop off, I guess.
No, you're still criminal.
Yeah, you did try to still kill the Ruby Phoenix. We didn't forget that.
Yeah. How do we call a guard?
Lord Rong says, but we did that in a past life, so we can't be held accountable anymore.
That's not.
No, that is bullshit. That is bullshit.
We don't know if you're still able to be controlled by whoever sent you out here, so no way in fucking hell are we letting you go.
That is true.
Lola looks a little troubled. Sanku, but my boy, hold on for a moment.
Mm-hmm.
Something to consider.
Yeah?
If we do send these people in, the Ruby Phoenix will hear about it, won't she?
Yeah?
For the sake of argument, what if she is involved in all of this?
Masami.
Yeah?
Do you think that... I hate trying to tell you to use the Golden League, but... Do you think that we could keep them with them?
The Underground has no amount of... They have a decent amount of interesting characters around there. You'd actually
you have a
fit
private
in,
prison we can use.
A private prison? I mean, oh, maybe if so you bad. Count like a back alley room, but you know,
I think they're both looking at each other, and Lord Ron says, who are the Golden League?
Organized crime. It's my family. Masami, I think, goes deeper into the alley, and like, I think they send out their snake summon.
Mm-hmm.
And they go, you know how this goes. Get Faye. And if Hiroshi's with them, get him too.
Okay. I think we'll jump forward a little bit. Faye is cuffing these guys with chains and, you know, kind of snickering as she's pulling them into the nearest entrance into the place, which is conveniently not too far. Hiroshi has his arms folded and he looks and says, of all the things you could have told me would happen with these guys, I would not have guessed this.
Yeah, it took me by surprise too, but thankfully we have someone who is a Jiangshi expert.
Chuji gives a shit-eating grin.
How does this fit into everything, Dan? What were we thinking?
Dead end.
Again?
They said, I mean, they got their memories possibly wiped. Either that or they just can't remember shit after being brought back to life. Mm-hmm. All we know is a portal came into their cell when they were on the ship. And there were five people. The one who opened the portal and then four others that were there. They experienced a lot of pain. Then when they woke up, their one desire was to take us out. A ritual with a modified memory.
Sounds to me that you've got someone really strong, not liking how much you're investigating them. Although, it looks like that if these guys are involved, then their dislike from you goes back to before you started properly investigating. This happened before you got here and made contact with me. Look, tomorrow's another day. I can leave you guys to it. You've got a tournament to win, and you've got one less problem to worry about now with Devil's Dues off your back. You guys gonna be okay?
There is one more, though, and I think both you and Faye should keep an eye out yourselves.
Uh-huh. What's up?
There's another person tailing us who is far better at tailing than those two.
His brow furrows and says, give me a description and we'll keep an eye out.
Looks like an old man hunched over, shoulder-length gray hair, very raggedy-looking. Likes to stare.
Okay. We'll keep an eye out, and I'll let you know if any of us see anything.
Good.
Ready for tomorrow's fights?
maybe after I go to bed, possibly.
Well, you guys get some rest. We'll take it over from here, okay?
Thanks, Geezer.
He turns and looks at you, Chuji. Yeah?
Yeah.
Say anything and I'll tell them what you told me.
He looks at you, Masami.
Masami has a shit-eating grin.
He grins right back. It's the same smile. And he says, right. Okay. Masami, Sanku, Chuji, have a good night. And Chuji, if you see your mom, send my regards.
What? Huh?
What?
And he leaves.
What does the... What?
Chuji.
He called my bluff. I was gonna threaten him.
Chuji looks at Masami.
Over his shoulder as he's walking away. As he's walking away, he says, in a hostage situation, the easiest way to de-escalate the situation is to shoot the hostage. And he walks away.
What?
Criminal organization. Yeah, he said that your mom taught.
Chuji grabs Masami by the fucking shoulders. Your dad fucked my mom?
You know, I have never been more glad that I have two married parents.
Masami?
I'm pretty sure he didn't. He would have probably said something. He also said they were like a
your
son
siblings.
To
him.
No!
Your siblings, and there's nothing you can do about it.
You seem glad to have you learn jellyfish stance.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Do you guys want to head back home?
Sure.
Yeah.
Dice Will Roll will return after these messages. We now return to Dice Will Roll.
Well, head home you do. You guys get a good night's sleep. And we're going to cut forward by a few hours after you've trained up in the morning and talked to everyone to being in the Ruby Arena. Day 5 of the Ruby Phoenix Tournament and the finals of the Loser's Bracket. Senku, Chuji, and Asami. You all sit with each other eating snacks as Tagata Eni flies above, hyping the crowd up once again, as you've gotten so used to by now. As her voice echoes out, she says, hello, Goka! Hello, Tiansha! Hello, Galarian! Are we all ready for the fifth day of the Ruby Phoenix Tournament? Yesterday, we saw our first teams being knocked out when Speakers to the Wind and Winter's Roar were eliminated from the tournament. Their images flash up on the screen a little bit, and, you know, despite everything, they all seem to be in good form. You see Teacher Ayawari waving broadly, then turns back and you see Trough, like, flexing before it comes back to her and says, now, the winners from yesterday, Kino's Toughest and the Biting Roses, they're going to have to prove themselves against the people who entered the loser's bracket in round 2. These are people who won the first round of the elimination tournament but were knocked out. Out of these 4, only 2 will emerge to take on the champions of the winner's bracket. We've got... And the screen flashes. Kino's Toughest and the Biting Roses versus Arms of Balance and Steps of the Sun. The crowd is cheering for these people, and each of the teams looks ready. Liang Shen hides his face with his fan. Vavana Watergase just kind of nods pleasantly. Tino Tung jumps up in the air and punches the air. And Yarika Mulandez, she kind of summons her ghost grandfather to pose with her. Tagala Emi circles and says, "Now, I present to you all Lady Hao Jin to present our matchups for today. Lady, if you will." And it turns to Hao Jin, who stands up and conjures a ball of fire. It says, "The first match of the day will be the Biting Roses versus the Arms of Balance. The second match will be Tino's Toughest versus Steps of the Sun."
My fucking god, I hate you.
Pain, agony, pain, agony, pain, agony.
I fucking hate you, you're the worst.
The crowd cheers, and Hao Jin bows a little bit before sitting down. Tagata Emi circles above, and she says, "Alright, everyone. That's going to be happening in the afternoon. But why don't we hype ourselves up a little bit first? Today, we've got our biggest and brightest exhibition matches so far. After all, today's the last day for the exhibition matches. From here on out, our matches are going to be focused exclusively on the tournament itself and highlighting the best fighters in all of Galarian. We hope you'll watch and give it your all as the most dangerous and exciting tournament matches you've seen so far unfold before you. As a warning, today's fights are not for the faint of heart. They will be death-defying and world-shaking stunts." And she kind of grins and waves a hand. And she starts calling out the matchups. And it actually looks like you guys are going to be facing off against Tino's Toughest in a mystery round.
Hmm.
Chosen by Hao Jin herself. But from the way that Tagata Emi describes it, it's going to be really, really dangerous. How are you guys doing as you are, you know, I think are like watching this, discussing, prepping? Because you'll be doing this soon.
I mean, Chuji's ready for the exhibition match. But they are anxious for the outcome of the loser's bracket.
I mean, Seku's excited. It's another chance to prove that he's really strong and awesome.
I think Masami is, they have their attention split, I think, between the exhibition match and the fights upcoming. Mostly because they don't want their friends to lose.
Yep. Maybe you guys should have made friends with these guys. Maybe it was a detriment.
Bitch.
Hey, you got one team that's a rival out of us.
Maybe you'll be able to kick their asses.
I can hear that smile.
Yeah, you can. Do you guys wait until your match begins?
Yeah.
Okay. So we're going to skip forward a little bit. The three of you stand in the center of the arena. You're all in your costumes. And you really have no idea. I don't think even Tagata Emi knows what this is. Looks like Hao Jin handpicked this one for its dangerousness.
Hmm.
And stepping in front of you all is going to be Tino Tung, Gig the Big Goblin, Malako, and Zumi. Tino steps forward and he kind of like is grinning and says, "Hey guys, check us out. We're not out of running yet."
I'm proud of you.
Yeah, congrats.
Hey, I don't know how we were able to get a win over Winter's Roar. We're not going to make it through today. I think we all know that, but you know what? This is the most fun we've ever had, right?
Hey man, you made it really far.
Don't catch yourself out yet, old man. Denial is a pretty strong thing.
Malako sighs and says, "Yes, and we have been training quite hard. I do think we'll be a match for Steps of the Sun." And Gig says,
"We won't know until it happens. But right now, why don't we focus on this? It's going to be a lot of fun, whatever it is, right? Sounds dangerous."
Zumi just kind of shrugs and says, "Well, whatever it is, I'm sure it's something that a little bit of fire won't beat." She winks. And Tina says, "How about you guys? You guys think you'll be able to take on whoever it is that gets through?"
"I think so."
"Oh, for sure.
I think we'll be fine."
"Hey, proud of you all. Now, you ready for this?"
"Yep."
"Fuck yeah.
Let's get to it."
Okay. Tino turns and bows to the Ruby Phoenix. And she nods and she turns and looks down at you guys. Do any of you bow back to her?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
The Ruby Phoenix raises a hand and Tagata Emi says, All right, everyone. And now we begin our match for the day. Lady Hao Jin, are you ready? And Haojin smiles and she speaks and says, "Oh yes, I very much so am." And she waves a hand and kind of appearing on the floor before you, behind you all, come an object behind each of you. Rowboats. Just sitting in the middle of the arena. And she smiles and she conjures up a massive portal in the middle of the arena, in the sky above it, and from it comes torrents and torrents and torrents of water. And that water very quickly begins to flood the arena. You guys hop into the boat, lickety-split, and within seconds, the entire arena is like a fishbowl, teeming with water. It's fucking Ponyo up in this bitch. There are countless fish. And it's at that moment that your eyes all glance down and you see what it is in your little boats. A strange device, like a long stick with string and bait.
God.
It almost looks like a
Stop it.
A fishing rod.
Senku is like, oh.
I have a feeling you're going to get
TPK'd. Senku's like, oh, wait. I was raised for this.
The water begins to churn, and Lady Haojin claps her hands together in delight as characters appear in the air and fireworks behind her. And it says, "The Fishing Challenge."
Oh my god.
Lady Tagata Emi starts to swirl above and says, That's right, everyone. It's the most dangerous sport in all the world. Each team has been equipped with several fishing rods, and they must hook in as many and as large fish as possible. The teams with the most and largest amount of fish by the end of it will be declared the winner. And the match will end. It'll become obvious when the match will end. I should point out, by the way, the water is not still. It is like churning. And when I say there's fish, I'm saying there's so many fish. Like, every single wave, you can see schools of fish going. Some fish you've never even seen before. And some, down in the depths, are very, very large. So, I want you all to roll initiative. And the team that has the highest initiative total is gonna go first.
Senku is very happy.
Chuji is frightened. I love this. Chuji hates this.
Oh yeah, Chuji, the boat is rocking.
Chuji fucking hates this. Chuji's having the worst time of their life today.
Chuji, that sucks because you and the Radiant Winds are going to go first. So the way that this works in mechanics terms, right, is you guys can all roll either athletics to grab the fish out of the water.
Yeah.
Survival to fish, or a relevant lore skill to use your things you've learned from the past. With you, Senku, I will allow dragon lore to work.
Thank you.
You don't know when this fight is going to end, so you'll probably have to figure out whenever. But Chuji, you're going to go first. Your options at the moment are just to either row the boat 20 feet or to fish. And if you decide to fish, you're going to need to make me one of those rolls I said. And then there's something else, but we'll get to that in a second.
Okay.
What are you going
to
do?
Well, Chuji's going to roll athletics to grab those fucking fish out of the water.
Okay.
Because it's a plus 29, that's higher than anything.
Mm-hmm.
Phoebe, Chuji has to roll a fucking flat check every turn not to die.
If you want, I will let you roll fortitude saves to see if you can stomach being seasick and give you a bonus if you succeed. But if you fail, you'll become sickened.
That's fine. I'd like to do that.
Okay, make me a fortitude save to start.
Okay. 40.
Okay, you're good for now. I'll give you a plus one on your athletics. As the boat is churning and swarming, and you see so many fish, it is nauseating. What do you do?
I fall into the water!
No!
Okay, so unfortunately, Chuji, you do fall into the water. With a nat 1 on your athletics, you are immediately caught off guard and you're like, bleh, 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 and you just fucking immediately drop in. And Tagata Eni says, Chuji's fallen into the water. Could they be afraid of the sea?
Can they hear the announcer?
Yes, it's a very loud voice.
They're like thrashing in the water and they're like, fuck you!
Unfortunately, Chuji, that will be your whole turn because this isn't a regular encounter.
Okay.
So you have fallen in and you're just...
It's that one scene from that one anime dub. I don't know what it is, but it's the guy like swimming across
the swimming pool
in the worst way possible.
Yeah. All the people who use Tumblr between 2015 and 2016 know what we're talking about.
Yeah.
Oh god.
You know.
Masami, it's your turn. Chuji fell in the fucking drink.
Can they get them out?
Yes, I will allow that, but you'll have a -2 on your check.
Okay.
And you can see Tino and everyone else has cast their lines and are already starting to fish.
Okay. No, Chuji's like thrashing in the water, like, now get the fucking fish!
Are you sure?
I'll throw them in from the water!
Okay, I guess. Man, their survival is not as good as their athletics. I'm gonna go on a limb and say Underworld Lord doesn't apply here.
Have you ever sold or bought an illegal fishing rod?
I'm not sure if Masami even knew that existed.
Well, then you don't. You can't, okay. I'm afraid.
Senku had to tell Masami that that existed once.
And Masami probably had to go through their contacts like, Hiroshi, does this actually fucking exist?
So unfortunately, at the moment, survival to fish normally allows to just snag them out of water and throw them back in, or relevant lore skill. Or if you have something else, I will allow it.
Actually, wait, hang on. I need to check what the action's for. Oh, what if I gravity well them?
Now, that's an idea, Masami. Would you like to?
Yes.
Okay. Masami, you stare at the fish for a moment. And like I said, there's so many. Salmon, anchovies, catfish, carp. And you close your eyes for a moment. And then you start casting. And you conjure up a ball of gravity in the air above your ship. And you start pulling seawater up towards it. And I'm immediately just going to give you an automatic one fish point. That's not to say you caught one fish, but that is like you have, without doing any fishing, managed to grab several of them and throw them into your boat. Okay?
Okay.
And that's what I'll give you for that. Next is going to be you, Senku.
It's true.
Senku, you love fishing.
Yes.
This is literally what you're best at. You have a fishing rod, right? You got it right here in your hands? You want to use it?
Yeah.
Okay, make me a survival check.
No, I would like to roll Dragon Lore instead.
Oh yeah, a Dragon Lore check even. Yes, yes, yes.
42.
A 42 is going to be a success. Thank you. You swing your rod into the water, and now you have to catch your fish. And fellas, your world is about to change. We are playing in Foundry Virtual Tabletop, where people can make mods. Any mod. Including this one. I have put a button out on the floor. Senku, press the button. Press the button, Senku. Click start fishing, Senku.
Oh god.
Fishing minigame?
Senku, a Stardew Valley style fishing rod has come up in front of you.
Oh,
would
shit.
You like... press the space bar to catch the fish.
Okay, it's a space bar?
Yeah. It's the spacebar controls the bob. Okay, you got this. Come on.
I wanna try.
Come on. Come on, boy. You can do it. Catch the fish.
I've almost done it. Hold on. I'm so close. I did it.
And when you succeed, you roll a D1001. Someone made 1001 catchable fish.
Oh my fucking god.
What?
What the fuck?
Will you roll me that D1001, please?
730.
Senku, you have caught a sand eel. You clutch it in your hand and it wriggles around and you throw it into a boat and you pump your fist in the air. And you have caught a fish! That's another fish point, bringing you up to 2 fish points.
Yay!
Next in the order is going to be Tino's toughest. And you can see that they're all struggling, they're all fishing, and they're going to roll a d4 and they get 3 fishing points. So right now, it's 2-3. And Tagata Eni roars out and says, looks like the fishing match is getting really heated right now. Chuji's fall into the drink, but Masami and Senku are managing to catch fish on their own. But can they outspeed the deadly power of Tino's toughest?
And Tino from a... power?
Tino from across the arena, as the waves are churning your boats up and down, he says, "You guys, you're outclassed in this one. I might not be the best fighter, but I've taken my kids on countless fishing trips." And unfortunately, then his eyes widen. Because that's when the big fish emerges.
Oh my god, it's Kahozuna.
Pulling out from the water comes a shape. And it breaches, and its beady eyes look around, splashing these tentacles around as its weird, cartilaginous head flops in the water. And everyone, it's a grand calamari. A giant squid. And it lets out a weird noise, and it enters initiative. And, together, Amy says, No way, a giant squid! Could this be the thing that, could this be the, victory gold that, Ruby Phoenix was talking about? So everyone, giant squid. The way to end this match is to beat it. The team, beating the giant squid will earn you a shit ton of fish, but also, you won't be able to fish on turns where you are pulling this thing up. And it is out. It is here, and it's going to use its whole turn to start, being pretty, squiddy, you know? It has, it's going to use its tentacles, from where it has emerged, and it has a reach of 25 feet. So even though it's far away from all of you, it's able to hit everyone. And it swings a tentacle down. Masami, it's going to go for you first. And when it hits you on this turn, you are... Crit fail. Masami, I'm going to let you make a counterattack as this tentacle comes down towards you.
So I just attack it?
Mm-hmm.
Sick. 46!
That's going to be a crit. Masami, you cut off one of its tentacles. How much damage is that?
It launched a tentacle, and Masami fucking jumped and did a spin in the air and fucking chopped it off. Double of 19, that's 38.
Okay, you cut off one of its tentacles, and the giant squid... And the crowd cheers! You're going to be rallied for that. As Tagala Amy says, looks like Masami Takahara is well accustomed to making calamari. So you guys are being cheered for as the crowd is rallied. The squid now turns, and rather than attack you, it's going to inkjet away from you all. And it's going to move 200 feet away from you all.
Yo, Jesus.
Sploosh! So it actually darts to the other side of the arena, up to the corner. It is very far away, and it is not going to... it's just taking a moment to recuperate before it comes back. Shuji, it's your turn. There's a way to not have to fish.
Yeah?
If you take down that squid, you will be able to earn a lot of fish on your own.
Shuji starts swimming.
Now, the problem is, it's 200 feet away.
Okay, what's my swim speed?
You don't have a swim speed. I think you would literally need to roll the swim check over and over again, and I don't think you have a very good swim. I mean, you have athletics, but, like, you're not going to be able to get 200 feet away.
Hold on. I have to wait until my turn to be able to do this. But I can help you.
I'm looking something up real quick.
Because I can cast Water Walk. I could do that for you, but you'd have to wait until my turn. So if you use your turn to fish, and then you let me cast Water Walk, then you'll be able to move towards them.
Let me look something up. Let me look. Oh, hold on. Ah, fuck! I was trying to game it, but no. 55 feet per second. Oh, wait, no! Wait, a round is how many seconds? Three?
Six.
Six? Fuck. Damn it! Okay.
What were you trying to do?
I looked up how fast you have to be to run across water.
There is a monk feat for it. You don't have it, I'm afraid.
Yeah. Okay.
Good try.
Oh, fuck. If you can cast that on me, I'll kiss you on the lips.
Mm-hmm. Just use your turn to fish for now, okay?
Yeah. Chuji tries to grab a fucking salmon out of the water.
Okay. Maybe an Electro roll. You will have a minus one on this toll because Rally boosts you up, but you are in the water, so that's a minus two.
That's fine.
What the fuck? All right, Chuji starts drowning.
So that's a nat one, Ritz, I'm afraid. I think in your panic, you try grab onto the side of the boat, and in doing so, you unfortunately knock Masami's fish into the water.
Oops.
Ah. So you're back down to 1 point.
Ah, fuck, I'm sorry.
It's fine. It's fine.
Masami, it's your turn. What are you gonna do?
I mean, I guess they're just gonna try to fish, question mark?
Okay. Athletics, survival, or an appropriate lore skill?
33.
A 33 with Rally of the Crowd is gonna do it. Masami, will you please start fishing for me?
Okay.
Come on, you got this. Let's go.
It's staying at the bottom. Oh my god. Just staying at the bottom.
Okay, come on. Start you that bitch.
Okay. I did high score in fishing for a reason. It gave me a lot of fucking money. Got it. 333.
Nice. What do you get?
I got a frogmouth catfish.
A frogmouth catfish. It's a big one, Masami. You hurl it in and it goes and it starts slapping around. But you put it in the bottom of your boat and you've got it. Let's bring you up to 2 fish points.
Huh. Okay.
Okay. Sanku, it's your turn. You fished in less than you'd like, but Chuji is not dealing well with this water. What do you do?
Sanku's like, please, please, please beat that thing. And he's going to cast Water Walk on Chuji.
Okay. Chuji, you are pushing. You're stomping on the floor. When suddenly, it's like the water is more like a weird solid, and shakily you get to your feet, and even though the water is trashing all over the place, so it is going to be we'll say difficult terrain.
Mm-hmm.
You are standing and the crowd cheers for that, and Degata Emi says, unbelievable, she's standing on the water thanks to the magical powers of Sanku, wind prince of the sea. Looks like radiant winds are really in their element right now. Chuji, maybe not entirely true. But hey. But hey. Chuji, we're going to have to wait until your turn to be able to capitalize on that, right?
Mm-hmm.
It is now going to be Tino's toughest turn. And most of Tino's toughest keeps fishing. But Malako spends 2 actions bursting giant crow wings from his back. And he says, my skills are needed elsewhere. And they point at you, Chuji, and give you a thumbs down. And then they start flying. So with their turn, they're going to move 50 feet closer towards the giant squid.
Piece of shit.
The rest of Tino's toughest continue fishing. And that's going to be another D3. So that's 2. They have 5 fish right now, bringing you to be 2 to 5. Risky, risky, but maybe you'll be able to make it pay off. It is now the giant squid's turn. The giant squid sees Malako coming, and it's going to spend 1 action to slap at Malako with its barbed tentacles. And that is going to be a 33, which is a hit. And it does 2d10 plus 13 slashing damage. That is 29 damage as it wraps around Malako midair, and that's going to be an improved grab. Malako is snagged by this squid. And Malako's like, ah! As a tentacle wraps around his their midsection, and they start being flailed around in the air by a giant squid, which burbles. With its last 2 actions, it's going to jet back into the center of the arena, pulling Malako along behind them. And it looks like they're coming in for a counterattack against the horrible team who cut their arm off. Chuji, it's your turn.
It got closer. Chuji is going to get right up to it. Then Chuji uses 1 action to get up because it's less than 55 feet away and they're using hopping stride.
Okay, you're literally Ponyo style running on the waves, jump, jump from wave to wave.
Yeah.
It's great.
And Chuji is in stone flame stance.
Okay.
And they're going to 2 action, 1-inch punch.
Okay, go for it.
Suck my balls and dick. Every time I've rolled a nat 1, suck on it.
That's going to be a critical hit, Chuji.
66 damage.
Ooh! The crowd cheers as Chuji, you lunge up and you cut off another one of this giant squid's tentacles. It... as it falls into the air, water, searing. And I think Sanku is able to kind of pull it up from where they are as it's thrown over. And Tagata, and he calls out and says, Unbelievable! Looks like the radiant winds really have it out for this giant squid. They have their eyes on the real prize. The crowd is cheering and you guys are rallied again.
Chuji kills.
Masami, it's your turn. Looks like Chuji's got the fucking giant squid under control. But it also looks like Tino's toughest are fishing up a fucking storm over there.
Well, I think I'm just gonna keep fishing then.
Okay, go for it.
That is a nat 20 survival roll?
Okay, Masami, you're gonna hook in the big one.
The big one.
The big one.
Okay.
Roll me that fishing check. Well, I'm rolling a D1001.
Okay.
And Masami, you have rolled a 574.
Okay.
You pull out a massive fucking fish. I'm saying immense.
Mm-hmm.
You have pulled up an albacore, a long fin tuna.
Yo, sick.
Ooh.
And it weighs 33 kilos.
Hey, does anyone want sashimi?
Oh, yes. Yes,
that's nearly
do.
70 pounds.
God damn.
You pull up this massive fish, and you have to nearly bear hug it and hold it down and push that down. That's two fishing points.
Yo.
Bringing you up to 4-5 against them.
Okay.
Sanku, Witch Prince of the Sea. Masami has fished up a fucking albacore, a giant squid is fighting against Chuji, and Tino's toughest are fishing as hard as they can. What do you do?
Senku's going to... Yeah, I think he'll keep fishing.
Okay, maybe not Dragon Lore check?
Oh.
No.
So,
no.
Fuck you. Give me fish,
how?
Please.
How? How did you...
Senku is a little fisher boy.
That's
thank
a nat 20. Okay, Sanku, will you roll me that D1001?
Yes, I will.
Oh my god, Sanku! You pull up a fucking shark!
I was literally thinking that in my head. Wouldn't it be funny if I caught a shark?
It's a fucking tiger shark! And you're wrestling it, it's biting a bit, before Lolo lunges forward and nips at it, and it goes limp, because Lolo's a killer. That gets you a total of 6 points, bringing you guys into the lead. And Tagata Emi up above, as the sea churns beneath her, says, Look at that! The Radiant Winds! They're on a roll, having caught two massive fish! Meanwhile, will Tino's toughest be able to keep up? Let's find out. Tino's toughest don't keep up.
Good.
Oh no!
They only get one fish. You see Tino's easily fishing up the rest, but poor Zumi and Gig are not keeping pace with him. It's Malako's turn. He is currently grabbed by the giant squid, and they let out a "Get off me!" and they swing their sword down, trying to break out. And that's going to be a 34, which passes and cuts into the giant squid's tentacle, letting them out of the way. They're no longer immobilized, and they have escaped. Flying into the air, they squawk before they drill down with a beak attack. And that's going to be... Unfortunately, that is going to be a miss against the giant squid with a 23. The squid turns with a beady eye, and Malaka with their last action is going to try one last time. Can they land a hit? No, they cannot. That is a crit fail, unfortunately. And the giant squid is going to make a counterattack with one of its tentacles. A 30 to hit is going to be a miss against Malako. So just in time, Malako pulls out of the way. That's going to be the end of Tino Toughest's turn. And it's back up to the giant squid. The giant squid is not very appreciative of you doing that, Chuji. In fact, it's going to try to grab at you. So it swings its barbed tentacle down on you.
Okay.
Unfortunately, that's going to be a 32 to hit. So it misses you, Chuji. You duck out of the way, rolling through. And it kind of, like, squints.
Mm-hmm.
And then it does something terrifying.
Uh-uh.
Ravenous Embrace.
I'm sorry, what?
It raises up four of its tentacles and starts fucking slamming. It's going to attack four people. So first against you, Chuji.
Okay. Shaking.
Does a 41
it
hit.
Does.
Okay. It's going to slam into you. And that's going to be 21 damage.
Okay, I'll take it.
And it grabs you.
Ow.
The giant squid is going to attack at Malaco, trying to grab him again. That's going to be a 38, which is going to be 20 damage. And it's going to bring another tentacle down on Gig, the big goblin. That's a 34 against Gig, which is going to be a hit, doing 25 damage to her. But more importantly, distracting her from her game, meaning that she's going to have Tino's Toughness will have another minus one to their roll next turn. The giant squid is then going to attack at Sanku with his tentacle. Uh-oh.
Oh, good lord.
Sanku?
Mm-hmm.
That's a nat 20.
Yes, it is.
Meaning that you're going to have a minus three to your next fishing roll, which is less than ideal.
It is less than ideal.
That's going to be 40 damage to you, Sanku, as this tentacle slaps you across the face.
Ow!
And the giant squid burbles. It's running out of arms as everyone keeps cutting it off. But it is mad. It's slopping around. It's going to kill. Chuji, it's your turn. You are in the grasp of this giant squid. It's not looking great. You've done some serious damage to it in the past. And you might be able to make some calamari out of this thing. What do you do?
I think that Chuji is going to flurry of blows. And if that doesn't do it, they'll take the risk of doing one inch punch after to just try and kill it.
Okay.
I'm willing to take the risk.
Oh my god, you're kidding me.
It's a critical hit and a hit 44 and 34.
Uh-huh. Well, roll me that damage, Chuji, as you're fucking going ham.
46 and 30.
My smile falls. How much damage is that total?
That's 76 damage.
The motherfucker had 71 damage. Or 71 damage. Chuji, how do you kill the giant squid?
Chuji, honestly, can I say that Chuji takes the limb that it cut off from it and beats it to death with its own tentacle?
Why are you
standing on top the waters?
I will absolutely allow that. Chuji, you slap the ever-loving shit out of this giant squid. And the squid lets out a burble, burble, burble. The squid goes limp and starts to float. And you have killed one of God's most beautiful creatures.
Chuji's last...
The rare and mysterious monster.
Could Chuji's last action be trying to lift the squid up with all their strength?
Make me that fight roll.
They just want to boast.
Got it.
44.
44.
I was going to make this the very hard DC because it's a massive creature. The very hard DC is 10 plus the regular DC, which is a 34.
Oh my
it's
god.
Like nothing. Chuji fucking lifts it by the head by one arm. Fucking what the hell?
Chuji, you are standing on the water as it churns and you lift it into the air and scream. And the crowd roars. That's going to be 3 fishing points. And with that, a whistle shoots through the arena. And Tagata Emi says, that's it! The giant squid has been slain! It's time for both teams to compare their catches. The water is drained. The boats are brought to land. And you all stand with your catches. Tino's Toughest has caught a perch. A juvenile sea serpent, saltwater salmon, a pufferfish, and a large carp, bringing them to 5 points total. Radiant Winds have caught a sand eel, a tiger shark, an albacore, and a giant fucking squid. to gather any, looks at the prizes and looks at them all and grins and says, that's it, everyone. We have our winner. The Radiant Winds keep up their invincible win streak and have won the fishing challenge. And the crowds cheer for you. How are you guys all doing?
Chuji is screaming, jeering.
Senku is very happy. I think he in particular feels happy because this was something that was relevant to him. So he's in a really good mood.
Do you shoot a look over to your family off in the stands?
Yeah, I think he does.
I think they're smiling. They're like on their feet, cheering and waving. They're so happy about this.
I think he waves to them.
Tagata flies down and says, and for your prize, we bequeath upon you a staff of power. And this is a immensely magic staff. It looks almost like a fishing rod, the way it's fashioned, but obviously it is topped with a silver sculpture of a massive salmon. But the point is that while wielding the staff, you will have a shit ton of extremely powerful spells that don't use spell slots. Spells such as Continual Flame, Globe of Invulnerability, Magic Missile, Cone of Cold, Fireball, Lightning Bolt. Goodness gracious.
What?
And you can also use it as a staff to home run people if you so choose. As an actual stick.
Hell yeah.
On top of that, both teams earn 4,000 gold pieces.
Slay.
Who's taking it?
I take all the gold pieces.
You take all the 4,000 gold.
You cannot be doing this.
I can. Chuji sees the staff and they're like, oh, Masami, you could use that, right?
I mean, I think so.
Isn't that your class of magic?
The spells seem... Oh, yeah. It is arcane, so I could use all of it. Definitely good if I don't have my spell slots. I don't have a lot. Alright, I guess I could take it. Another weapon.
Tino comes over. He slaps you guys' shoulder, congratulating you. He even makes a comment about how you're even better fishermen than the world's greatest fisherman.
Sorry, I was raised in a fishing village.
Oh. Oh, that explains it then, huh? I just like to do it for a hobby.
That's okay. There's nothing wrong with doing it for a hobby. It's just my heritage.
You guys retreat to the stands.
Senku's walking back and he's like, okay, but I really want fish though. I want fish.
We literally caught a bunch of fish.
Do you think we can snag back that albacore?
I want that squid.
How big do you think we can make calamari?
I will say, I will allow Chuji to use the squid as monster parts.
Yes! Yes!
Chuji takes one of the calamari rings and uses it as a necklace.
You ready to watch the fight?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Ugh,
after a few more exhibition matches, it comes time. Time for more teams to move forward and more teams to lose. Everyone, first battle. Arms of Balance versus the Biting Roses. From the very first punch, it is an intensely fast match. That's the thing that strikes you most about it. It is fast! We see Raunak Yan use his staff to propel himself into the air and conjure up a shield of steam that blocks an incoming card throw from Lantondo. Lantondo ducks out of the way of a fireball that is thrown at him, and he pulls up another card, the Juggler. A massive giant appears behind him and is juggling an elephant, a boulder, and more, and he drops all of them atop Bumat, who punch, 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 each of them exploding into sand. Sunita spins through the air, whistling out cold air as she does, and blasts a winter storm directly into Artus Rudrivan, who shoots a flurry of arrows through it nonetheless, striking into her with a flash of white light. Grandfather Mantis goes toe-to-toe with Bavana Watergase, who charges each of her attacks with lightning, blocking and parrying against these Mantis claws. Behind him, you see Yavika kind of throwing together hand signs and conjuring up a ball of occult energy, which she zaps into her. Bhavana stumbles back, and as she's stumbling, Sunita swings forward and blasts another ice beam into Grandfather Mantis' face, causing both Yarika and Grandfather Mantis to stumble over in pain. Bumat comes over, dropping a powerful kick into Yarika's side, knocking her to the side, and while she's knocked over, Grandfather Mantis still stands and duels against him. Lantondo shoots a volley of arrows, and Lantondo conjures up the Rakshasa, a crocodile-looking gentleman who is full of tricks. He darts around the field, surprising and confusing the arms of balance, and that's the opening that Atris Rovidan needs to push forward. It's an intense and long fight, but in the end, the last fighter standing is Atris Rodrivan of the Biting Roses. But he lets out a tired breath before punching the air, and a crowd cheers as Tagata Emi says, And that's it, everyone! The Arms of Balance are KO and have been knocked out of the Ruby Phoenix tournament. The Biting Roses will re-enter the winner's bracket as our first of the champions.
Yes. Yes. Oh, wait, no.
And the Biting Roses cheer. They're really happy. And the Arms of Balance, some of your first friends in this whole tournament, they slowly get up. They're not mad. The better team won. Congratulations are shared, and they throw their hands into the air, happy to be a part of history. How are you guys all feeling as this match ends?
Shuji's very happy that they won. But also they don't want to see them fight again with the fucking Steps of the Sun.
I think Senku is happy. He likes both of these teams. So he didn't have to worry about like if somebody won, he'd be unhappy. But he is sad that somebody had to get knocked out at all. He knows that this is how tournaments work. He's just sad about it anyways.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think Masami was just happy to see the fight. They like both teams. They're happy that the Biting Roses won, but damn.
Yeah. Damn. Right. Well, surely it's not going to get worse, right?
Yeah, surely. Oh,
the cry of Sway the Celestial Rock echoes through the arena. Liang Shen, Junxiu, and Halsman the Stung begin their battle dance as Tino's toughest stand defiant against them. So far, Tino's toughest have coasted through on pure luck this entire time. It was luck that they were able to best Winter's Roar with a lucky punch. It was luck that Tino happened to help you take on these villains, the Devil's Dues atop Mount Haminabu. It was luck that they even got into this tournament in the first place. But is luck enough to overcome pure skill? Because that is what Steps of the Sun are packing, and it shows. Everyone fights hard, but Liang Shen fights like a man powered by the very sun itself. As he swings through the arena, he gets an early KO on Zumi as he swings forward with an uppercut with his fan, knocking her flying and then following up with a spinning kick, knocking her into the floor and leading her KO. The rest of Tino's toughest quickly move on to the defensive. Gig the Big Goblin throws her hammer, swinging through the air like a boomerang at Sway, who blasts it back with a laser, knocking it down. But as Sway is distracted, he looks up and sees Gig leaping, turning into a massive creature and grappling against it. As this is happening, Junxiu sings and beautiful melodies materialize in solid form, swinging through the battlefield like a blade, cutting into the flesh of Malako, who attempts to parry but parries too late. Malako grows crow-like wings and swings towards Junxiu, who dodges out of the way, but their attack still lands true on Halsman the Stung. Tino and Shen duel. And I think, Shuji, you're the only one who knows, but it's obvious that Shen can empathize with Tino. Mm-hmm. Their reasons for being here are very similar. But that's not going to stop him from fighting as hard as he can to win this. After all, he got a note yesterday. He has a promise to keep. It's fast and it's furious. Sway is knocked KO by Gig the Big Goblin, who is in turn knocked out by Halsman. Halspin struggles against Malako and loses. Junxio shoots blades of sound at Malako, which does knock him out. But moments later, Junxio falls to the ground unconscious, knocked down by bleed damage. Tino is looking battered, and Liang Shen is not. Shen relaxes a little bit and powers up a dash across the arena, ready to cut Tino in half. Tino puts a lay on hands on himself and calls out to Rory at the last second. And as the fan cuts into Tino, Liang Shen's eyebrows go up because they never made contact with him. They hit the holy armor that Tino conjured up when he used lay on hands. That plus one AC is all the difference. And Tino's eyes widen and he capitalizes on the situation. And he delivers a powerful punch into Liang Shen's gut, knocking him flying and leaving him
K.O.
Oh my god.
What?
Masami crosses their arms. They cannot believe it.
Senku's jaw is dropped.
How's Juji?
Stunned? They're like standing up in their seat.
And Tagata Emi says, "Unbelievable! From the bottom to the very top, it looks like Tino's toughest have pulled true, and they're back in the winner's bracket! Steps of the Sun have been eliminated, meaning we have four teams left in the Ruby Phoenix tournament. The Radiant Winds, the Biting Roses, the Light Keepers, and Tino's toughest. We'll return tomorrow, everyone, with day six of the tournament, the semifinals, where the most impressive matches between the strongest fighters will unfold.
I can't fucking believe it.
Oh my god.
That happened?
Yeah, it did.
Chuji's mouth is just like agape. They're not saying anything.
I think Senku's yelling Tino today. He's very happy.
Shen gets up. And he bows shortly to Tino before leaving the arena quickly. Halspin and Junxio, they stay a little while. They congratulate Tino's toughest. They're very happy with them. And honestly, even if they don't win, they've still got everything they needed. They have what they need to help Liang Bao. They have everything they need to bring their village back from poverty. Everything's great. And it's good to see Tino's toughest win, right? And yet Shen leaves. Looks like there's going to be festivities. Who's going to it?
Chuji's not.
Oh, Chuji, where are you going? That's weird.
Where do you think they're going?
I think Chuji is traveling to Absalom.
I think Judy's gonna go visit their mother. Yeah, like, where do you think?
Yeah, they're gonna go to their mom. No, they go look for Shen.
You find him. He's back in the Ruby Village. Sitting behind his house. Kind of slumped.
Mm-hmm.
How are you approaching this?
Honestly, I don't even know. Chuji doesn't even know how to approach this. They see him in... in his Ruby Phoenix, like, village house. Oh, God. I'm gonna cry. I'm so sad, genuinely. I think they stand like a good distance away.
I'm so sorry.
Shen looks up at you, and I think when he realizes you're there, there's like a snap to his head, and he says, "Woof. I'd ask what you'd want, but you've made it immediately obvious. You're here to pity me? Is that it?"
No, Chuji? I don't know.
Why else would you be here, right? come to check on poor helpless Liang. Poor helpless Shen. Can't do anything. Can't win a single fight against a group of nobodies.
I came to check on you, not because I think you're a loser. I wanted to know if you're okay.
What do you think?
I'm gonna wager a big fat no.
Obviously not. And the worst part is it doesn't matter if I'm not okay, because we still got what we wanted. Bao's going to be fine. Our village is going to be fine. And here I am, throwing a hissy fit. Childish. It's my fault. I didn't fight hard enough. That's what it comes down to. I should have spent more time using my magic to buff my allies instead of going in for flashy KOs. It went to my head after I knocked out the Kitsune, and then I thought I could take them all on, and it's my fault.
I think Chuji walks closer, and I think they sit not right next to him. They're gonna give him his face. They're not stupid.
It's not your fault. I'm kind of stunned about it, honestly. Because watching you...
He cuts across you, Chuji. And he looks at you and says, Bao wouldn't have lost. Bao would have been perfect. She would have been even-tempered and chosen the right targets at the right time instead of letting her ego, her will to be the best on the field get to her.
Bao isn't here. You are here, Shen. And you did your best.
And my best wasn't good enough.
Your best was good enough to get you here. Don't you think that's something?
I'm a failure. That's what it comes down to. I'll go home and everyone will tell me I did amazing and all the good I did for my home, but what does it matter? They all know that I'm the shadow of the sun who couldn't win the tournament proper. I mean, what's the point of fighting if you don't have something to fight for, right? I think, Chuji, as he's saying this, you hear something happen. Or rather, you kind of see out of the corner of your eye as someone goes, hey, you two having a moment? And Tino Tung steps around the corner.
Chuji looks at Shen.
Shen's eyes immediately look like that of a starved wolf. And he just throws his head back down and says, ah, more people here to pity me, are we? Come to laugh at the Azumar who couldn't shine bright enough, are we? And Tino puts his hands up. Hey, man, listen. I know what it's like. I know what it's like not to do as well as you'd have liked. And I'm not here to pity you, because there's nothing to pity. You're one of the strongest goddamn fighters I've ever seen. Right, Chuji? You can back me up. Shen's good at what he does, right?
Too good.
You had me dead to rights, Mr. Liang. And I know it's hard sometimes to fight for people who aren't here, but put it this way, isn't it better to have lost than to have not tried at all? The things you accomplished, the stuff you've seen, even if you didn't win today, that doesn't mean that your story's over. You're going to keep going out there and doing amazing things. Because you're amazing, Mr. Liang. And you got people who care about you and want to see you keep being amazing. I think Shen is listening, and as Tino says that last bit, for just a moment, his gaze turns to you.
I think they catch each other's gaze for a second. Before Chuji looks away again. And they say...
He also looks away.
Suffocation.
Look, if you want to be beat up about something, then be beat up about how you broke my promise.
And Shen just laughs annoyedly and says, oh, trust me, if you want to fight me again, I'll happily do it anytime. And there is like a bit of vinegar to it,
mm-hmm.
but he catches himself, actually, I think. And he stands up and says, I need time to think. I request that you don't follow. And Shen kind of gets up and walks away. And you're just left there with Tino for a moment, Chuji.
Ugh. Chuji, like, puts their hand on their face and they drag it down.
I think Tino sighs and slumps beside you. He's quite a character, huh?
Sure is. Man, you and your last second comebacks.
I guess I fight hardest when I'm cornered, right?
It's the best time to fight.
Yeah, but I can tell he really wanted that win.
He needed it.
Did he?
As much as I need it.
Maybe in a way it's better he didn't win. What would have happened if he had won, Gigi? He would have just reinforced in his head that no matter what happens, he has to keep winning. Hey, take it from a loser like me. That's not the case. And not everything's gonna go your way, but when it does, it's like a miracle. I've got a feeling that Shen's story is far from over. He's not gonna fade into obscurity because he lost one little fight, right? Kind of punches your shoulder. I get the feeling that's the same for you.
No.
Good. Keep fighting for him, Shuji. Take it from me, I know what it's like to fight for someone you love.
No, wait, it's not.
Huh?
That's not...
I mean, I was talking about, like, you know, the way I love my brother, the way he loves his sister.
Oh, yeah, no, totally.
Uh-huh. Totally, right?
Shut the fuck up, man. Come on.
Hey, I'm not... Not gonna pry. It's not my business. But, hey, if you never need some advice on wooing a partner... he's been married for 20
Stop,
years
shut
now,
up.
You know?
Stop talking.
My fucking God.
Shut the fuck up.
Hey, whatever you say, man. Apparently we're going to be facing off against the Lightkeepers in our rematch.
Good luck with that.
You know what? I'm actually pretty confident. We've been on quite a streak.
Well, hey. Keep that streak going, okay?
Only if you keep yours. I want to see you guys into the finals.
Fucking bet we'll be there.
Puts a hand on your shoulder and says, hey, no matter who ends up winning the Ruby Phoenix tournament, we'll do it for our friends, right?
Right.
Or our warden friends?
Oh, fuck off! And then Chuji pushes him away.
Oh, to be young and in
love. I'm not in love.
He slowly stands up.
It's not.
You basically came out and said it. I would not have picked up on that in a million years.
I was clarifying that there's nothing. I'm not doing this with you.
Who would you rather it be with, huh?
No one.
Don't want to ask dear old... Okay.
This is coming with me until I die.
If you say so. Keep fighting for him. He kind of winks.
Mm-hmm. Sure. And they kind of feel like the back of their hair.
And you feel where a ponytail once was, but is no longer. He stands up and says, I'm going to head back into the city. Festival's in full swing. You coming, or Do you want to wait around for Mr. Shen?
I think I'll wait.
Good choice.
Tell anyone, I'll fucking kill you.
Hey, I may be a gossip, but not when it comes to that kind of thing.
Good. See you, old man.
See you around, kid. And Tino Tung leaves, and not too far away, standing behind a cherry blossom tree, Liang Shen cleans his nails a little bit. And I won't say how close the cherry blossom tree was. Maybe it was too far to hear, maybe it wasn't. The tournament's almost over. The semifinals will start tomorrow. Championship is within grasp. Maybe the hardest part is over, maybe it's just begun. But there is no time to stop fighting. This episode of Dice Will Roll would not have been possible without the support of our patrons. Sam Stryker, Soken Ashra, Erica, Tony Saunders, Mita, Ari Graham, Arave, Nex, Minty Belmont, GP Dora, Lemon Jam Tart, Marshmallowberry, Ferric Falcon, Luis Loza, Ares, Alexander Criswell, May Cohen, Skyly, Kendra West, Genuinely Tricked, Transgirl Trish, Platonic, Bal Punya, Johnny the Catman, Matthew Wilson Krasnovich, Tillam Shark, Glitch HD, Jay Snooks, Zenith Drums, Torbjorn, Sophia Valera, G Barbera, Luke, Gideon, Sarah B, Seth, Rivona Darklow, Kira, Lichelope, Gizmo, Matthew, Cass, Fable McElduff, Ava, Chris Luttman, Rem T. Bright, Lonesome Chunk, Steph, Sean C, Natasha Lunley, Rhiannon C, Ellie, Jenna Mitchell, Kane Kendrick, Triceratops, Grey Kitsune, Anna Maria, Roxy, Jordan, Cynical Spinstress, Emily Laderna, John the Bookhorder, SS66 Seeker, and Dame Valerie the Third. Special thanks to the patrons who made cameos in this week's episode. Liang Shen by Ren, Malako by Fable McElduff, Gig by Gizmo, and Zumi Rain by SS66 Seeker. If you'd like to see what you can get for helping us keep it rolling, check out patreon.com/dicewillroll today!